And first of all, Congress Keith Ellison, welcome to Somali My TV for your beautiful time.
Oh, very pleased to be here, Mahatsen.
All right. Okay, let's get together of these things. I mean, I don't have a lot of questions for you. A lot of young people want to become a politician and also one day want to go to Washington, D.C. Is going to Washington, D.C., would you expect it?
I certainly would expect it, particularly from the Somali community. I think the Somali community has a lot of political talent. Mm-hmm. People who speak and write well and communicate effectively, people who know how to work in groups, mm-hmm. and know how to pull people together around a common purpose. This is something that we need to do, and where every single day we're seeing more and more people get involved in the political process. So when it comes to young people, I tell young people, make sure you study hard, mm-hmm. be involved, and read and follow politics, and then ask a lot of questions.
Wow. All right, let's get this together. I mean, what is at stake in November 4th election?
There's a lot of things at stake. Mm-hmm. War and peace, for example. The United States foreign policy should be a policy where we reach out to the rest of the world, build friendships, strengthen democracies around the world, help strengthen countries like Somalia, help bring peace, stability to Somalia based on a Somali solution. Or we could have a policy that represents John McCain, mm-hmm. where warfare, fighting, military solutions are all we have. So I think that so war and peace and U.S. relations with the rest of the world are at stake. Also, the benefit of the American middle class. A lot of people, including many people in the Somali community, are trying to start businesses, work jobs, whether that might be a small restaurant or a cab business or something much bigger. We need to strengthen the American middle class. That means the Somali middle class too. It means we need people we need to have better wages. We need to have health care for everybody. 47 million Americans with no health care. We've got to solve this crisis. You know, LeBan, if we have, there's a lot at stake, middle class prosperity, war and peace, immigration reform is at stake. We know that John McCain started out being an advocate of immigration reform, and then he backed off because he was afraid of the political heat. Yeah. We need people who are willing to stand up and be counted and stand up for comprehensive immigration reform so that we can have greater justice in this area. And then also we need to close down Guantanamo Bay. This is something that I think is very important, and we need to make sure we have greater civil and human rights. So all these things are at stake. Schools are at stake. We're going to reauthorize No Child Left Behind. This is a federal school administration law, and we've got to make sure that young people are getting a good education, including Somali young people. And we also have to have an urban policy that helps us to bring more peace among our youth. As you know, there have been a lot of Somali youth fighting and getting shot these days. Yeah. We've got to have an urban policy that says we're going to go to our young people, work out the critical problems facing them, and try to make sure they have a future.
So there's a program for them, for those even young people who are shooting themselves.
That's right, because look, you know, you have a lot of young people, maybe they're 16, 17 years old, maybe their parents are immigrated here, maybe they were born here. Yeah. And in some cases, there is a divide, a cultural divide, because their parents are from another culture, speak another language, and they're here, and some of these young people feel very angry and frustrated and feel like society doesn't have a place for them. So we've got to be able to join together as a community to make sure there's a place for these young people and that they have a real future.
Wow. You know, I mean, the election is very important.
Yes, it is.
So can you tell us why the Somali communities are very important for the election?
Well, the Somali community is critical. In my own election, I wouldn't be in office without the help of the Somali community. Okay. Somali voters came out in very large numbers and were able to register people to vote. Very recently there, I think there was several thousand Somalis who were just naturalized as U.S. citizens. Yeah. Somalis can make a huge impact on this election. And I can tell you without a doubt, it's not just in Minnesota that Somalis make a big difference in the election. Also in Ohio, which is a battleground state. Somalis that are in Columbus, Ohio, and in Virginia, all have a role, an opportunity to play a very big role in this election. And so I think many of us are counting on the Somali community to get involved, stay involved, but not just vote, help others vote. On my campaign, we have tremendous leaders. For example, Hibu Isak, who is a great leader, very articulate, very smart young lady, who is out gathering in Somali voters and other voters to get them to the polls. Also, we have Miriam, who's on our campaign, and others as well. So we believe that the Somali community is a critical, plays a critical role, not just in Minnesota, but in Ohio and in Virginia. And so call your relatives out there so we can get them to the polls.
Wow. We know that the election is very important, that we said. And why is it important for people voting, not for yourself only, but Barack Obama and Al Franken? Why?
Right. I'm not the only one on the ballot.
Yeah.
There's a number of them that are on the ballot. Barack Obama needs your vote, needs your support. Let's make sure that we have a president who really understands Africa, because his father is from Kenya, and really understands the importance of the U.S. having a good, strong policy to help strengthen Africa. Let's make sure we have Al Franken in there. Al Franken is a person who has supported policies that will help the Somali community, working people, health care for all, and education for all, and has been an opponent and a critic of this Iraq war as well. So I think he would be critical. But not only that, there are several other, there is something called a referendum on the ballot for more funding, greater funding for Minneapolis public schools. There's a lot of Somali children in Minneapolis public schools, and we need to fund the public schools so that they have smaller class sizes, English as a second language classes, and more assistance as they integrate into the public schools. We know that the pathway towards a good life, a middle class life, wealth, and prosperity is education. And so we've got to make sure that our Somali youth get what they need in school. That means we got to support the referendum. Vote yes on the referendum.
Well, we know that schools are very first, for the community. It's
absolutely
good to get education and stuff, things like that. And why is it important for people voting this strong schools and a strong cities referendum?
Well, the strong schools, strong cities referendum says that we cannot have a strong city if the schools are weak. Mm-hmm. We cannot have a strong systems in our city if young people are not being educated, don't have an opportunity. Mm-hmm. Where is it that we get the entrepreneurs, the people who open the businesses, the people who are doctors, and the people who are lawyers, and the people who are engineers and social workers? It's because these people have pursued education. In fact, even in your own profession, Levon, of being a journalist, you have to go to school. You have to master reading and writing and the skills associated with reporting the news.
Yeah.
And so without strong schools, we have a weak community. So we need to have strong schools in order to have a strong city and strong people in our city.
So to get those strong ones, in which way, how do you think you can get it?
Well, I think we got to vote yes on the referendum.
Yeah.
But one thing I want to say to you, that in we don't want to have a system where you have one big politician, he's a big man, and he does everything.
Yeah.
We need, democracy is about getting everybody involved,
absolutely,
about everybody helping to get out the vote,
yep,
everybody voting for their best interests. And then you tell me, as a politician, what you expect. You say, Keith, I expect you to help deal with this Somali youth violence problem. English as a second language, strong schools, health care, better jobs, fairness for our taxi drivers, things like these. These are all important issues, and I depend upon people to tell me what their needs are.
Wow, thank you very much. In your campaign, there's a lot of people are involved in your campaign.
That's right.
But why, how is the Somali community involved in your campaign?
Well, we have several members from the Somali community who are employed on our campaign, and they all do a great job. As I said, Hibu Asak is a great leader, very smart, very wise lady, very well trusted in the community. But also, we have my good friend Hashi Abdi, who's everybody knows Hashi.
Yeah.
And Hashi is a great leader, very smart man, good friend of mine, brother of mine, really. And we also have Miriam. We also have a lot of people who are working with our campaign and a lot of supporters who may not be employed by the campaign, but who really feel good about the campaign. And so this campaign, what I'm saying is I'm asking the Somali community to help me get elected so that I can be of greater service to the Somali community, so that the U.S. policy in Somalia will be helping Somalia strengthen, stabilize, and create democratic rule. And so here at home, Somali Americans can start jobs, go to school, have education, stop community violence, in these important issues to improve the quality of life.